In this session, we'll discuss about the current and current density. So let us consider a surface S. So let us say the charges are flowing through this surface S. Okay. So let us consider that charges are flowing through this surface. Okay. So let us say that the amount of charges that are passing through this surface, let it be in delta q in time delta t. So this ratio delta q by delta t, that is the amount of charges which are passing through this area per unit time, can be defined as the current. Or when this delta t tends to 0, this I is defined as dq by dt. Okay. So it is the rate of flow of charges through this surface S. Or it can be defined as the current through a given area is the electric charge passing through the area per unit time. Okay. So now let us consider a cross section delta S of this surface. Okay. And for the moment, let us consider that the charges the current is normal to this surface. Okay. And let's say the current that is passing through this area is delta I. Okay. So in this case, we can define another quantity known as current density. So the current density is given by delta I by delta S. Or we can say that the current density at a given point is the current through the unit normal at that point. So here it is nothing but the current per unit area, and this delta S should be normal to the, here in this case it's normal to the, is normal to the flow of current. So in this case we can define the current. So this that is current density. So this current density J has the unit of amperes per meter square. Now let us say that suppose if you have the surface S, okay, and let's say the current flow is in this direction, and consider an area ds as shown here, and the current density at this point is, let us say, J. Okay. So we know that the current that is passing through this small differential surface ds can be written as j dot ds. And the total current, so this delta I is the current which is passing through this surface ds. And if in order to find out the total current which is passing through the surface, we can integrate this quantity over this surface, or it is given by j dot ds, integral of j dot ds over the surface. So this is the relationship between the current and current density. And now, so far we have not discussed about the nature of the current density. So depending upon the charges, there are three kinds of current densities, or depending upon the type of charge flow, there are three types of current densities. One is known as conduction current density, other one is convection current, and other one is displacement current density. So let us consider now the convection current. The convection current flow will occur because of the flow of charges, okay, in an insulating medium. Okay, so whenever charges are moving in an insulating medium, this results in convection current flow. So example is, we have flow of electrons in an electron beam in vacuum, let us say. So here the important point here is, in convection current flow, no conductors are involved. So here the charges are flowing in an insulating medium. So let us try to obtain an expression for convection current density. So let us consider a region where convection currents are flowing. So here, let us say we have charges which are flowing in this direction. Okay. Now let's consider this part of the region, and this has area delta S, and this length is delta y. Okay. And let us say rho v is the charge density, and these charges are moving through this region. Okay, so this is convection current. Okay, because here the charges are flowing in some insulating medium. Now let us try to find out what is the current that is passing through this small area delta S. So we can see that the current that is passing through this area delta I is, from the definition of current, is given by the amount of charges which is let's say the charge that is passing through this surface in time delta t is delta q. Okay, so here I'll repeat again. See here, let us say this the charges which are present within this region. Okay, so within this region, the total charge which is present within this region is, let us say, delta Q. And this charge delta Q passes through this surface delta S in time delta T. Okay, so in that case, the current is given by delta Q by delta T. Okay, now this charge delta Q is given by the charge density into the volume divided by delta T. So here this volume is given by, we know that because this length is delta Y and this area of cross section is delta S. So therefore this volume is given by delta S into delta Y, delta T. So we can write it as rho V delta S into delta Y by delta T. And we know that this quantity delta Y by delta T is the velocity of the charges. So here U Y is the velocity at which the charges are moving. So this delta I is given by rho V delta S into delta Y, or the convection current density J is given by delta I by delta S, or rho V into U Y in this particular case example. But in general, the convection current density can be written as rho V into velocity vector. So here we have to remember that J is a vector quantity. Okay, so J is a that is current density is a vector quantity, and whereas current is a scalar. Okay, please we have to remember that I is scalar, whereas J is a vector quantity. So the convection current density in general is given by this expression. With this, we will end this session.